Alright guys, serious question here. Have you ever pulled in your goose hunting field to find other dudes in there too? Like a little permission, miscommunication, mishap type error? Instead of being little boys and,
oh yeah, permission first, this and that.
You know what you do? Hi there, what's your name? Well, my name's Jim. Nice to meet you. Yup, my name's Jaren. Let's shoot up some birds. In other words, shake his hand like you're a real man. And go kill some honkers together. Welcome back to another video.
That is your 5-pounder right there. Yep, that's it. Oh my god, it's a huge
one. Look at that fish.
Just absolutely
clobber. There's no gobbler.
No, but a little backstory here. Before the video starts, I wanted to get this straight. Let me get this off autofocus. Alright, little backstory. So, I wanted to get a goose hunt on film this year, which I really want to get a lot more this year, now that I got this one on film. So my buddy Derek texted me the other day. Let's go teal hunting. Alright, let's do it. Well, that falls through. Don't go teal hunting. But, he gets permission for this goose field. Alright, you know, going to get a goose hunt on film. Like, all right, sounds good. Let's go do this. So, get up at like 2 in the morning, typical. Me and Derek's at 2. Noah's there, one of our buddies. So, we get in the car, drive to field, whatever, get there at 3:30, get the decoy set out, the layouts are all set up. So, we're all good to go. By 4:30, we're all set up, ready to go. Well, comes about 4:45. Oh my god, I'm not used to vlogging. This is my arm's tired. We're like, wow, getting kind of hungry. We got like 2 hours till sunrise, keep in mind. Sunrise is like 6:22. But anyways, we're like, let's run a quick trip. Hey, okay, so back when Derek got permission for this field, which is a couple days ago, farmer's wife told Derek, well, there might be some other guys that'll be hunting there. So we're like, well, if we get there early enough, we got dibs. So yeah, we pulled in at 3:30, got everything set up. The mosquitoes, I don't know how to really describe this. I'm sure a lot of you hunters know and have seen some pretty bad mosquitoes, but I've been in a lot of mosquitoes. I personally have never seen mosquitoes this bad. I mean, it was so bad that you pull your freaking brim of your hat right down, zipper your hood right up here, and you just sit there and just suffer. It's like from a horror movie. It's living hell, literally. So that alone was irritating enough. But we worked through it. We got everything all set up. So we were already kind of cautious of other guys pulling in there. So we're driving to Quick Trip. We're literally on the road. Like, we just get on the road heading to Quick Trip. And we pass a guy with a decoy trailer. Like, oh boy. So Derek pulls the truck around. Catch up to this guy. It's not him. We're like, whatever. So we sit in the field entrance a little bit, waited to see if they'd come back, and they never came back. So it's like 5 o'clock now. We're like, screw it, we're going. So we run a Quick Trip, grab a couple donuts and juice or whatever the heck. And we're driving back to the field, and we're literally driving alongside the field, the side of it, because we had to get to the entrance or whatever. And there's headlights out in the field, walking around. We're like, oh boy. So, you know, you never really know how the guys are going to handle it. So we pull around. We park in the entrance. We didn't even know where the truck was. We couldn't see their truck. So we park the truck, walk down there. First thing, but by the way, long story short, these guys are awesome. Brady and Garrett, freaking awesome guys. We're like best friends now. But anyways, we walk down there. Garrett goes, I'm assuming you guys have permission too. We're like, yeah. Well, mind if we hunt together? So they pulled their blinds over by our blinds and we got it set up and everything. So that was, I mean, it was fine. So now it's like 5, I don't even know, probably 5:30. Getting kind of light out now. It's like getting to that time. We walk back to the truck. We're going to park the truck, get the rest of our stuff. And another truck pulls up with a big old decoy trailer. Like, well, we kind of assumed it was with these guys. We thought it was the same group. So we're like, oh, no big deal. It's the same guys, whatever. No, it's a whole other group. So, we get back up to the truck. Dude hops out of this truck with a trailer, and he looks at Derek. He goes, Derek? So Derek's like, yeah. Comes out, it's Dylan. It's this guy named Dylan Gerbunder. right? And I know Dylan too. So Dylan's like, yeah? I'm like, yep. So I'm like, who else is with you? Goes Carter. Well, you guys know Carter. Carter's this guy right here. Absolute deer slayer. But anyway, so I went and talked to Carter. So then we talked for like 20 minutes. We're just waiting for the sun to come out, whatever. Well, they ended up driving off. So now we go back down by our new buddies, Garrett and Brady. And that kind of leaves us at the starting point here. Didn't really know each other at all. I told them that I like filming YouTube videos and that I wasn't shooting, and it kind of irritated them a little bit. No, I'm kidding. But so yeah, that's kind of where we're going to start the video. But pretty much the moral of the story is, if you pull into your goose hunting field and there's some random dudes in there, introduce yourself and shoot some birds. Stay tuned.
Clinch Outdoors is brought to you by Drexel Building Supply, supplying happiness since 1985, and Sportsman Journal TV. Get the most out of your time on the water.
Noah. Dirt. What's up, buddy?
Not much.
Where's the birds at?
Don't know. Riley's still sleeping.
A couple other guys down there. What are your names again?
Garrett, that's Brady.
Brady?
Yeah.
Alright.
Next one, yeah. It's my bad for...
Holy shit.
Oh my god. Oh my... Oh my god.
It don't matter.
Holy
I don't care.
Holy.
No, get down a little bit. Take it. Hold on. Roll back up, because some of the partners might. What one? Alright.
Well, that one might come back.
That one might come in. That was awesome!
I don't know if I hit a bird, to be honest.
That's my first shot. A couple over there. There's one down over there. Way over there.
Yeah, my first shot I definitely missed, but the next two.
With flocked heads.
They probably just got shot at and they're coming back.
Alright, Garrett, so tell us what happened today.
Oh, well, me and you guys and my buddy, we've been scouting this spot for about a week. And we've seen birds in here. They've been feeding in the morning. There's a private body of water that holds a lot of birds on the roost. So we knew there was going to be birds around here. and it was rainy and cloudy this morning, so they weren't off the roost really early. Hold on. I see there's more geese over there. Anyway, they weren't off the roost real early, so we were kind of just messing around this morning, shooting at pigeons and whatnot. And we were hearing geese over the tree line, and it was just a matter of time. There was a good 70, you'll see in the video, and they played the game like we needed them to, and it was in-your-face action.
So we got 2 dozen decoys. That's what we had set up.
It's all about. Thank God for our filmer. We would have had more birds if our filmer was shooting, but...
And we had one more over there.
That's Brady.
Brady.
He's chilling by the thermos.
Yeah, he's got a...
Mosquitoes are so bad.
Those geese are...
He's got a thermos over there, and he hasn't had a mosquito all morning.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's kind of the end of the video, footage-wise, but from what I understand, I mean, this was my first time ever goose hunting, ever. From what I understand, this early season stuff, it can kind of be like that, like, big old group, and then all of a sudden you're done. It kind of sucks, but I hope to film some later hunts, too, where, like, action all morning, you know, singles, doubles. Hope we can get more of that stuff on film, a little later in the season, especially when the bugs aren't as bad, that'll be nice too. But it was fun, it was extremely fun, and I think I'm hooked on goose hunting. So any goose guys out there, let me come film with you. Let's make some good videos. It was so cool, like, seeing how to set up all the stuff and how the birds came in. I mean, it was picture perfect. It was like, we figured like 70, 75 birds, because it was, the first group was easy 40-50, and then there was a smaller one after him, probably another 30 birds. But we obviously shot the first group that came in. So it was really cool. Glad we got a good video out of it. And I hope you guys enjoyed. You guys let me know in the comments if you like the bird hunting type stuff, because obviously the last video was pigeon, this is goose. Like, these are kind of fun to make, you know, a little switch up from fishing. And bull hunting's coming right around the corner. I'm actually leaving for out west on Thursday. Thursday night we're leaving, and we'll be gone for a week and a half, so probably, this will probably be that last video until then. We're elk hunting out there. We're going to shoot coyotes, try to kill an elk, do some trout fishing, so I'll do all that, I'll film all that for you guys, and have a good video when I get back, but there'll be a couple week break here. And then after that, we'll probably get right into deer hunting, and I got to design a bunch of clothing for a gun hunting merch drop, and then probably more goose hunting, duck hunting, whatever. We'll see what happens with all that. But thank you guys for the support. Hit the subscribe button if you're not subscribed already. We got to hit 1,000 subscribers. That'll be so cool. I definitely think we can do that. Thank you guys for where we're at right now. It's pretty cool. I like making these videos for you guys. So stay tuned for the next videos. Wish me a luck in Colorado. Give me an ox right here. A little fist bump. Good luck. Shoot a big old bull for you guys. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.